Hey guys, I'm Nate, welcome back to the workshop. Not too long ago, we showed you how to take a simple recipe and mix it with liquid nitrogen to make your own ice cream. It got me thinking that maybe there are some other things you could mix liquid nitrogen with for other kinds of desserts. So I wanna see if we can take soda and mix it with liquid nitrogen to make our own slushies. This process, I think, is gonna be pretty straightforward. We're gonna pour some of our soda into our bowl and then slowly add liquid nitrogen while stirring until we get the consistency we want. Unless it doesn't work, in which case this is gonna be a really dumb video. I bet it'll work. It's liquid nitrogen. Eventually, something will freeze. That's the goal. All right, here we go. I want to fill this cup with our slushy once it's all frozen, so I'm just gonna use this cup to measure how much soda to put in. Should work about right. Let's just try splashing in a little bit of liquid nitrogen and stir it up. The spatula is a really good tool for keeping stuff off of the walls, but I think I want something that will do a little bit better of a job of mixing the liquid nitrogen into the soda. Let's try the beater attachment to a hand mixer. I could use the hand mixer itself, but I think that might just be so vigorous that it splashes soda and liquid nitrogen everywhere. That's not my goal today. So I'll just use this by hand. You can see it fills up with vapor very quickly unless I blow it all out. We're already starting to get some frozen slush along the sides of the bowl. I guess that's when I want my spatula. And you can see that there is some slush already beginning to form down inside the soda. This is looking like it's going to work really well. Well, you can see it's definitely gotten thicker. It's to the point where I can sort of pile it on top of itself, which I think is a very good sign. I think we're getting pretty good results. Let's give this a taste and see how it's doing. That's really good. It tastes like a slushy made from soda. Almost all of the fizz is gone from this. Tastes really good though. Let's keep adding a little bit of liquid nitrogen and try and get it like a really stiff consistency. It's looking pretty good. It's nice and thick. It's kind of like, it's actually almost, I think, more of a snow cone consistency at this point. More snow cone, less slushy. That's really good. It's nice and frozen, easy to pick up with a spoon, has the same taste as the soda. Like I said, I think it's lost all of the carbonation at this point, but it's quite good. Let's try and scoop it back out of the bowl into my cup and see if we can get a nice cup full of slushy. Ooh, we had so much liquid nitrogen on the bottom of our bowl that it started to freeze some parts of it completely solid. Less slushy and more ice cube. Well, I think that works very well. We now have a cup of slushy. Tastes great. The consistency is really nice. Like, it's super, super smooth. I don't think I've ever had a slushy where the consistency was that smooth. Almost creamy, if ice can be creamy. Yeah, I really like that. If you've ever just tried freezing soda, other than just exploding out of the can or bottle that it's in, it sort of seems to separate a lot of the time. So you have just a chunk of almost unflavored ice and then sort of just syrup on the sides that didn't really freeze as much. This is very evenly mixed up, so it really has the same taste as the soda. Maybe let's try it with some other flavors. There you have it, using soda and liquid nitrogen to make yourself some delicious frozen slushies. It works very well, it goes very quickly, and overall I think it's a fantastic result. I was a little bit surprised that it completely seems to get rid of all of the carbonation in the slushy. It starts out very fizzy, of course, since it's soda, but by the end, it's just got a smooth texture with no fizz to it. I'm wondering if it would work to make this same idea, but using dry ice to cool down the soda instead of liquid nitrogen. Maybe the dry ice that has been cooled down in liquid nitrogen, so it's very powdery and extra cold. I think the dry ice would then help recarbonate the soda as it froze it. Or maybe it would still be so cold that the carbon dioxide can't dissolve into it. I'm not sure. Thanks for joining us for this experiment today, and remember to come get your hats, shirts, and other cool merch at thekingofrandom.com. See you there.
Seriously, does this stuff glow in a black light?
Hey guys, Grant here. Just want to pop in with a quick update that the King of Random brand is expanding. Nate's here because you wanted more DIY, more variety, more frequent videos, and together, we're all making that happen. Thanks for your support.